Hi, I'm Curtis Knight. And parent dances, or special dances, if we don't have parents attending, one or both, can be a very high impact segment on your wedding day. But I hear stories from people who have been to weddings, brides and grooms who just got married, and they say, oh, when it was time for the parent dances, you couldn't hear the DJ, nobody noticed the announcements, I didn't get to see this particular dance. It should be a really big deal, and that's up to your DJ MC. And if I'm the guy serving you, then it's up to me to make sure that it's presented in a really special way. So this is how I recommend that it be done. And if you don't wind up having me, these are some really cool tips that you can share with your DJ or your band leader. When it's time to have your special dances or your parent dances, it's important that everybody be in the room, both parents, the bride, and the groom. So let's make, for the sake of today's discussion, let's just say both parents are still alive and viable and with us, and they're both attending the wedding. So we have a father of the bride and a mother of the groom. What I usually do is I will go to the bride and groom at the appropriate time, which is about 40 minutes into the meal. I will walk up to the bride and groom and say, are you comfortably ready to do your parent dances, or shall I come back in a few moments? So usually they say, yeah, we're ready now. So then I say to the bride, can you go get your dad? And I say to the groom, can you go get your mom? And we'll all meet right back here, right here. So I'll be waiting. So they take off. She gets her dad. He gets her mom. Now there's all five of us. So we have John and Mary Smith getting married, and we have the bride's dad, who is Ron. So I'll say, Ron, you're going to be a key player in this. It's going to be bride-father dance first, then mother-son. And I want to make sure you're all four here when things begin, all the way through to the end of the groom-mother dance, which is going to be second. So in a moment, Ron, I'm going to ask you to walk to the diagonally opposite edge of our dance floor. Before you get there, I'm going to start to make the announcement. And I'm going to say, time for our beautiful bride to dance a special dance with her father. And when I say her father, that's your cue. Ron, you're going to start walking this way from the opposite diagonal corner. Mr. and Mrs. Smith, bride and groom, you're going to hold hands and you're going to walk from this corner. And you're going to head toward each other and you're going to meet in the middle of the dance floor. When you get there and you get right on top of each other, please go into slow motion. Don't be in a hurry, because everybody has their cameras and they're all trying to get photos and little video clips of you. So the longer you take, the better. A lot of times people are in a hurry because they feel like they're taking up people's time and I need to do this fast and I need to get out of here. But you don't. You need to make it last long and savor it. So when you meet in the middle, Ron, you're going to go right for our handsome groom, John, here. John, you're going to go right for him. And you two men are going to exchange a handshake and then pull it in, arms around the neck. Welcome to the family, son. I won't let you down, sir. Have your little conversation. And if you want to, you two can dance a little bit just for a few seconds. Up to you. Then, Ron, you are going to wait while your handsome son-in-law hands over his beautiful, stunning wife to dance with her dad. And then you two will start dancing. John, the groom, you're going to walk back over here and stand right next to your beautiful mom. And you two need to be laser focused on what's going on the dance floor. And the reason I mention that is sometimes while the bride's dancing with her dad, the groom will take off and go to his buddies and do a shot of tequila and whatever. And you can see it in the photos and the video after the wedding. So what you want to do is when the bride dances with her dad, the groom and the groom mom want to stand at the edge of the dance floor and watch lovingly while this happens. So at the end of that dance, I'll say something like, there's a daddy that loves his little girl, and there's a little girl that loves her daddy. Thank you, Ron. Thank you, Mary. And now, whatever the bride, whatever the groom's mother's name is, I'll say, Joyce, it must seem like only yesterday he was getting his little bath in the kitchen sink. And now here he is, all grown up, a big handsome man on his wedding day. Could you do us the honor and have a special dance with your baby boy? So then, groom's mother and groom will go to the center of the dance floor. They'll have their dance. And at the end of it, as the music is fading out, I'll say something like, Joyce, there's a reason why he is a wonderful guy, polite, professional, going to make a wonderful husband, and everybody here knows what the reason is. Job well done, young lady. So that's the parent dances. And if you do that little bit of orchestration so that the groom walks out, shakes hands with the bride's dad, it makes for really good photos and really good video. So the takeaway from this video is organize your parent dances or special dances, whatever they are. Make sure everybody's on the same page. The bride, the groom, the DJ, and whoever the people are that they're dancing with, make sure everybody is focused and everybody gets it, and you'll have a wonderfully presented special dance segment.